Welcome to this Wood Solutions presentation on best practice in wrapping and strapping packs of timber products. The basis of moisture content management in the supply chain is the assessment and control of the moisture content of timber and wood products in the pack. This video deals with wrapping and strapping the pack. The pack's wrapping is its primary protection from the hazards to the timber's moisture content, such as water, wind, solar exposure, and temperature extremes. The strapping protects the pack's integrity during the storage and transportation. The process of wrapping and strapping packs involves assembling the timber into a solid, robust unit on gluts, strapping the pack regularly so that it retains its shape, wrapping the pack with plastic and taping it into position. This can be before or after wrapping. For high value material, protection layers can be added to the top and bottom of the pack. The staff involved include those in the production operation preparing the pack for storage or dispatch, in the store preparing material for further storage or dispatch. The procedures required include procedures on pack wrapping and labelling and for generating feedback. The tools required include plastic wrap and packaging tape, corner protectors, support furniture such as bearers and gluts and feedback sheets. Packs should be prepared on a flat and level surface. The board should be placed on gluts. Where possible, the bottom and sides should be full-length boards. And straps should be regularly spaced and tight with protectors used on each corner to prevent edge damage. Packs should be plastic wrapped on at least the top, sides and ends. And the plastic should be taped in place.
So is strapping important?
Strapping the packs is very important, especially at the mill level, to keep the timber flat, straight and free of twist and warp. Typically in a 6 metre pack of long length material, flooring and the like, five straps, five gluts to maintain consistency through the pack and to stop any warping, twisting and movement in the pack where possible.
Delightful.
So these are the sent from the US.
Yep.
Packed with plastic sheet over the surface and again shrunk wrapped with plastic around the outside.
So there's plastic across the top and then completely around the outside as well?
Correct, yeah.
And they'd all come in by a container?
Container.
Do you unload the containers here?
Generally, yes.
Yeah. So it's from outside, straight inside?
Yep.
Yeah. Cool.
Any packs broken open should be rewrapped in plastic as soon as possible. And any holes or tears in the plastic should be repaired. Wrapping packs in plastic is always necessary, except when the appearance grade packs are exposed to external conditions in fine weather for less than 1 hour, and the structural grade packs exposed to external conditions in fine weather for less than half a day. Any pack likely to be exposed to rain should be wrapped.
We would typically, if it's a 2400 by 1200 sheet material, we will have sticks of timber underneath, which is also has a little groove so it can be used for the strapping.
Yep.
And we'll typically have four on the 2400 length. We will have still have the bottom sheet under the material, cover sheet, and one on the top. It will be shrink wrapped around for in the transport so that it will not absorb much moisture, and then strapped up.
Basically. And you do that with all product?
All products, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's even if it's just going down the road?
Even if it goes 3 kilometres down the road, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. In summary, the basis of moisture content management in the supply chain is the assessment and control of the moisture content of the timber and wood products in the pack. The pack's wrapping is its primary protection from hazards to the timber's moisture content. The strapping protects the pack's integrity during the storage and transport. and additional protection layers may be added to the top and bottom of the high-value packs.